They are yet to interact with you. Okay. How many of you have heard about the internet before? Then how many of you know your rights? Your rights.
In July 2014, 17 partner organisations held workshops with 148 children from 16 countries around the world that encouraged them to express their ideas about their rights in the digital age and the role digital media technologies play in their lives.
Participants were invited to make timelines of their daily digital media use, to discuss the challenges and opportunities of digital media and respond creatively to its role in their lives. There are extraordinary opportunities for children to enact their rights in the digital age. Yet what surfaced around the globe was a discourse dominated by risk and safety.
There's a need to redefine risks, opportunities and rights from children's perspectives. Overwhelmingly, children see digital media as a positive, essential part of life. They say it makes connection, knowledge, education and fun possible, and that without it, life would be far more difficult. Even though many children across the globe identify that they are engaging in similar online practices, they experience access to digital media technology in very different ways.
No, we go on again. Mm-hmm. We go on again. Right. We'll first use this key.
Okay.
To open it.
Okay, okay, go on.
Open it. Open it again.
Mm-hmm.
So, if you want to on the gen, come closer.
Okay, don't worry.
You want to on the gen, I press red button.
Mm-hmm.
It shows green light. I press his hand.
Mm-hmm.
Then I press this green.
For those children with access to digital media technologies, they are so embedded in their everyday lives that many find it hard to imagine a world without.
I can imagine because sebab saya sendiri lahir dengan teknologi. So, saya tak dapat bayangkan macam mana saya berdenet sebab hari-hari saya menggunakan internet dan menggunakan tiap-tiap hari untuk pelajaran, untuk segala keperluan yang sekarang ni memang sangat perlu.
Porque yo no podía por mi edad vivir una experiencia a cuando mis padres estudiaban debido a que allá solamente usaban la máquina de escribir. Pero actualmente tenemos una gran variedad de dispositivos electrónicos que nos facilitan mucho el encontrar la información, el no ir a bibliotecas y creo que eso es una de las cosas que ayuda mucho a mi vida.
We live pretty much on our phones, our laptops and everything, so it would just be really like lost without it.
Almost everything is interconnected these days.
The primary use of digital media in the lives of these children is to communicate with others.
We can use our phone to receive incoming calls.
Me comunico con mis amigos y mis familiares.
It helps us communicate.
It's a lot easier to get like involved in like projects or find out information about things.
Such connectivity is so embedded in everyday life that children say the online world cannot be separated from the offline world.
Untuk cari maklumat, kalau kita nak pergi jalan-jalan mana kan, kita boleh search lah tempat tu kat mana.
I learn in internet to do this that turns with the air.
Yo estoy haciendo un molino que sirve para orientarnos con el viento.
Yo aprendí a hacer un muñequito de plastilina en YouTube.
In addition, children with access to digital media technologies consistently see these tools as fundamental to their right to education.
It helps me a lot in studies and in also relaxing.
Forest setting.
Forest setting.
hago mis tareas en cualquier lugar donde esté. Inclusive las puedo hacer en la misma clase.
Ödevlerimde, araştırmalarımda, çalışmalarımda bilgilere bir tıkla ulaşabiliyorum artık.
That's you. Gain access to knowledge
and information.
I use the internet to learn programming.
Create an app to program.
When it comes to skills in digital literacy, children are generally aware that they need to critically evaluate the content they come across online.
Information yang kita dapat tu belum betul-betul sahih lagi ya. Lepas tu macam banyak gosip yang ada kat dalam internet ni kan.
Il y a des personnes qui mettent vraiment n'importe quoi sur internet. Et ça, c'est un peu. C'est pas très bien.
Not only does digital media foster social connectedness and education, it allows young people to participate on a global scale.
As a result, digital media is creating informed and engaged citizens of the world like never before.
It helps a lot of young people know about the news and what's going on.
Et on peut avoir aussi des nouvelles, par exemple, dans notre pays. Par exemple, s'il y a le Mali qui est en guerre.
With this unprecedented level of interconnectivity, new challenges have inevitably surfaced. Children identified that their digital media practices, even simply watching the news, can sometimes expose them to content they're not prepared for, impacting on their right to be safe from harm.
Kids these days have like really easy access to internet, and there's a lot of inappropriate things on there.
You're going to learn about more gruesome things and the harsh realities of the world younger. I've had to learn about things that I probably wouldn't have wanted to know just by going on just like BBC and CNN.
Videos that people post on either YouTube or Facebook about some very graphic content. The struggle is wanting to know what it is. You might have the urge to want to see the action, but you know that those actions aren't very positive.
Children also articulated a lot of concerns about the risks associated with their digital media practices. They worry about staying safe online and offline.
There's a lot like online bullying, which is a big problem in Australia because it's anonymous, so you don't know who's doing it. Mm-hmm.
Some people aren't very conscious of what they put on the web.
Muchos casos, por ejemplo, de bullying, que algunas personas, niñas, suben fotos semidesnudas o desnudas, entonces las otras personas también pueden tomar esas fotos y hacer de ellas algo malo o cosas así, en el caso.
I think a lot of us try to portray something on the internet or in social media that, yeah, we all just try to put on a persona, mm-hmm. and it can affect our normal day lives that's not to the social media, because we try to, I know we're mainly focusing on improving our social media personality rather than actually living our own like lives.
Adult discourses seem to be dominating the ways that children think and talk about digital media. A lot of children's concerns echoed the risks that are commonly identified in cyber safety education.
Des fois, on peut pirater notre site, donc du coup, on peut voir tout ce qu'on a mis sur des choses privées. Aussi, il y a le problème des photos qu'on peut pas effacer ou des documents.
La persona debería tener al momento de redes sociales es no aceptar a personas desconocidas y si las personas la intimidan, bloquearla de inmediato. Tampoco estar buscando como que personas que tú no conozcas en la vida real, porque tú no sabes en realidad qué puede hacer.
They put their address, they put their mobile phones, they are exposing themselves, like you posting something on Facebook, like your house. People already know your house. If they want to do something, just a click, they will be something.
My mom has played a big role in giving me this, creating this awareness in me. Because like when she first created a Facebook account for me, I asked for it, and she told me that there's this privacy settings, you have to set it in this way, that way, so that only people whom you know can access to whatever information you post and stuff. And she has also told me that, as I said, the world out there isn't as safe as you think it is.
It is clear from listening to children that adults and their concerns have a strong influence over the way children imagine their digital media practices. While cyber safety is important, we may not be enabling children the right to develop and express their own views.
The biggest challenge in this media, the adult doesn't trust us, so they thought that digital media is too time-consuming.
Children everywhere told us that digital media is crucial to their everyday lives. The need for their digital rights to be realised, in their own words, is therefore more important than ever before.
Acceder a los medios digitales me ha hecho la vida más fácil.
Just sets up my entire day.
And it keeps me in touch with what's happening in the world.
Given digital media is becoming more and more ubiquitous, a fine balance must be struck between ensuring the online world is safe while also allowing children to use digital media to fully enact all of their rights.
Children should have the right to form their own opinions. They need to be given the space to imagine their futures in their own terms. They want to be listened to and to have their digital media practices taken seriously. They must be part of the ongoing conversation about how we can harness the potential of digital media to enhance human rights globally.